So my husband and I bought our first home this August when we're both full-time entrepreneurs. It was a little trickier, as my mortgage lender may say, but we got the job done. We bought our home in August of 2020. So we bought it during the coronavirus pandemic, and we bought it and moved across country without seeing our house. More on that later, but we learned a lot of lessons during the process, and I'm gonna share what we learned. I'm Tonya Rapley, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I talk about all things entrepreneurship, Shopify, and being a mompreneur. Today, I want to talk about buying a home as an entrepreneur. This year, after 5 years of entrepreneurship, me and my husband bought our first home. A trickier situation to navigate, as our mortgage broker may say, but we got the job done and moved into our home this year. First time we saw the house was in the day of closing when we showed up in Atlanta to buy our home. And I'll share more about that later. We did qualify for FHA financing, which is something that a lot of entrepreneurs might not think is available to them. So I'm gonna share with you what we did in order to be able to qualify and some of the lessons that I learned along the way. Okay, the first thing you wanna do is make sure that you are planning with your accountant. I cannot say this enough. You wanna make sure that you have an accountant. You wanna make sure that you're planning with your accountant. You don't just wake up one day and be like, you know what? I wanna buy a house. Not as an entrepreneur, unless you're gonna buy that house cash. But if you plan to go for financing, you wanna make sure there are a few things in place. And working with a qualified, competent accountant was important, because all accountants are not created equally. Ask me how I know, because we've worked with a few in the past that actually got us probably in more financial entanglement. I'll say that. More financial entanglement than it actually helped. And my current accountant, Belva, was able to clean a lot of that mess up. And so what we ended up doing was sitting down with her and letting her know, hey, this is our goal. And we want to make sure that on paper, we are able to qualify for a home based on our goal. Because anybody who's an entrepreneur knows that paying taxes sucks. Like, it's the worst thing about being an entrepreneur, in my opinion. But you have to pay those taxes and make sure that you're demonstrating that you're bringing in money and able to demonstrate to mortgage lenders that you can actually afford to pay for a home. And so that was one of the things that we did with Bubba's. We sat down, and based on the home price that we were going to be applying for, we wanted to make sure that our income would qualify us for that. So we kind of backed into it. We looked at, okay, before we did our taxes, we said, this is about the home price, the general home price that we are looking at purchasing, and let's make sure that our finances can support this purchase. We needed to do that and make sure that we had it documented for 2 years. So we needed to make sure that our taxes were filed in accordance with this plan in particular for 2 years. That meant that we weren't getting those write-offs and so forth that we normally claimed, because the name of the game wasn't pay as little taxes as possible. It was demonstrate to the IRS that we actually do bring in money in our businesses and we can afford to pay our mortgage, and demonstrate that to lenders. So you wanna make sure that you're doing that. You're reporting your income and your earnings and so forth. And you wanna make sure that you have everything tight. You wanna make sure that your business is, like, you're operating a legitimate business and that your business finances are tight. You wanna make sure that you're in compliance and up to date with the IRS or any payment plans you might have with them or any debts that you might have with them. And you just wanna make sure that you have dotted all your T's and crossed your I's, because I will let you know, these things will come out when you get an underwriting. They will start asking you questions and everything else, and you want to make sure that you have your documents together. Another thing that I did when I was working with my accountant and then we started working with the mortgage lender is I created a specific folder that was encrypted that had all of my documents in it. So I had electronic versions of all my documents, and so that if I needed to provide something to them and I was in the car headed somewhere and they needed it immediately, I could get access to that information and send it to them, whether that is to my accountant and she's working on my taxes, or whether that was the mortgage broker. So that's another thing in having your documents in order. Make sure you have them easily accessible so that you can respond to whoever needs it with it as soon as possible, because time is money and money is time, and speed is the name of the game a lot of times when it comes to these financial transactions. Let's move into speaking about your finances and situating them more. So you wanna make sure that you have them in order, but you also wanna make sure that you've been doing things that you need to do, such as building your credit score, because it's really important to make sure that you have good credit when you're buying a home. At the end of the day, like, I know that, you know, credit is important. As a financial educator, I might be a little more credit focused than others, Something you can also do, say you're in a business that you're having to create a lot of debt to get that business going. Say you have to buy inventory and so forth. Grow those streams and grow that business credit, and so that you can begin financing stuff in the name of your business and not in your personal credit record or not on your personal credit report. And so no matter what's going on with your business and so forth, as long as you know you're still in good standing with it, but you might have credit cards, the balance may be a little higher than you prefer, but it's not reflecting on your personal credit. So that doesn't affect your personal credit score, which will also help you when buying a home. So make sure that you're minding your credit score and doing everything that you need to do to get your credit score in order. And if you have questions about that, I actually have linked to one of my MyFab Finance videos where I talk about things you can do to build your credit score. Next thing you want to do is make sure that you have adequate savings. And by savings, I'm not just talking about a down payment. A down payment is not the only money that you need when buying a home. There's earnest money. You have to pay for the inspection. As an entrepreneur, they wanted to make sure that me and my husband had 6 months of our mortgage in reserves, along with the money we were going to be using for our down payment and closing costs and so forth, because they wanted to make sure that if the economy did go sideways, we still would be able to pay for our mortgage and that we weren't a liability. So we needed adequate savings. We needed not just our down payment, not just our earnest money, not just our closing costs, but 6 months of what our mortgage was going to be to demonstrate that we were financially responsible and that we'd be able to take this mortgage on. So make sure that you are building your savings as well during this process. And depending on where you're moving, you might not need as much savings as we did. We ended up buying a house in Atlanta, Georgia, which is a lot more reasonable than houses in other areas we've lived in, such as New York and Los Angeles. But there are other areas around the country that are less expensive than Atlanta. So make sure you're building those savings reserves. And the last thing I'll touch on when it comes to your finances is, as a business owner, I actually have multiple accounts. If you've read the book Profit First by Mike McCallowitz, he recommends that you have multiple accounts. So I have bank accounts literally everywhere. Like, there might be a bank account stashed somewhere behind this chair or something. Like, I have bank accounts everywhere. And so it was important for me also to make sure I gathered all my documentation. And I only submitted documentation that was relevant to the home. They didn't need to know what was in like my personal or my business savings account, as long as I have money in my personal savings account and so forth. So make sure that you are aware of where all of your accounts are, and so that you can get that information, because they will need account statements from those different accounts too. The next lesson I learned is, be ready for the questions. You know, if be ready for the questions. Make sure that you are prepared to answer any questions that they may have. And you may submit your documents and they say, okay, everything looks great, and you don't hear from them for 20 days. And then all of a sudden, when you think it's time to close, they're gonna come up with all these questions. Hey, do you have this? Do you have this? Like, they're gonna ask all these questions that you're gonna be like, why didn't you ask me that 10 days ago? But you also have to understand, they're not just working your mortgage. They're not just working your deal. They're working hundreds, if not thousands, of other deals and so forth. So when your stuff comes up, you also want to make sure that you're able to respond, but be prepared for those questions. Don't get offended if they ask questions. I know that I feel, as an entrepreneur, my finances are actually more solid than a traditionally employed individual's, because I know what's going on with my money. Like, I know if invoices aren't clearing and if, you know, bank accounts are dwindling, we need to do something to bring more money in. You don't always have that luxury when you work for someone else. You might think things are going good and then you show up to work and the company goes out of business. Ask me how I know, because it happened to me. So be ready to answer any questions they may have, because they are going to have questions. And another thing you want to do when going into the underwriting process, ask the broker that you're working with if they have a lender that they've worked with in the past that is more flexible or more understanding of entrepreneurs. Because every lender doesn't enjoy lending to entrepreneurs, or every lender might not lend to entrepreneurs, but there are some that are more flexible and will lend to you. And so ask your broker ahead of time, maybe if they have some lenders in mind that would be more sensitive or understanding of your specific scenario and more willing to get the job done. So make sure you ask those questions, because there are hundreds, thousands of lenders and you have different options. And it's important that the mortgage broker that you're working with find the best lender for your particular deal, not just one that they like, but the best one for your particular deal. And the last tip I have is to keep working. Say you become, you know, you've been relatively successful this year and so forth, and you feel like, okay, now it's time to put it on cruise control. Let's chill. Something else that they asked of my husband and I were contracts from upcoming work. They wanted to see that more work was coming in. And so it wasn't like, okay, yeah, y'all had a good 2020 so far, good first 6 months of the year. Now let's see how the rest of this year is gonna look. Let's make sure that your business is still bringing in money. They actually asked for the contracts and we provided them with contracts and proof that our business still was gonna bring in money after we closed on the home. And understandably so, because some people can get all dressed up and present really well while they're going into financing and they get their financing and then they just slack off, or they don't have the same drive that they had before they got into their home because they know it takes longer to, you know, foreclose on someone. So they don't work as hard as they did before. It's important that you can demonstrate that you will still keep the same hustle going forward and that you'll still be bringing in money even after you close. And at the end of the day, that's what mortgage companies care about, that you're gonna be a good borrower, that you're not gonna cost them money, that you're gonna help make them money because that's what they're in this business for. But then you'll also be a good partner in your mortgage and they can rely on you to make your payments monthly, just as you rely on them to go ahead and give you the money needed so that you can purchase the home. So those are my quick tips. In closing, it actually took us 65 days to close on our home. I was hoping that we'd have a quick 30-day closing process, but with everything going on with COVID, the IRS wasn't processing paperwork and there were things that we needed from them. Things were just a little slower. Inspections were slower at the time. There were appraisals were slower. Everybody was backlogged and people didn't know how to execute a lot of these things with COVID precautions. And then, you know, we were coming out of lockdowns. And so the world was essentially opening back up. People had been cramped in their home. And so when we bought, the market was really competitive as it is currently right now, and this is the end of 2020. So the market is still really competitive, but we've already seen our home value increase from when we purchased our home back in August in this past couple of months. But it did take us 65 days to close. So they tell you it's gonna take a little longer. Have faith, have trust. It's not that they think that you're just this terrible borrower. It's just that they need a little more time to understand things and work out the kinks when it comes to your deal. It took 65 days because we wanted a 60-day close. They needed an additional 5 days to get some paperwork back from the IRS. I hope that this video has been helpful to help you understand what it took for us to buy a home as an entrepreneur and some of the things that you need to keep in mind. Feel free to ask questions in the comments below. I purchased my home in August, so it's still really fresh to me. Buying a home is one of the biggest financial decisions that you'll make, and I want to help support you during that process. As an entrepreneur, I want to see other entrepreneur homeowners. It was a big accomplishment for us. Even my mom told me, like, I'm really proud of you guys. You've done something that me and your dad, you know, weren't even able to do. We had to rely on our 9-to-5 income to buy a home, and here you and your husband creating a business out of air, and you're able to do things such as buy a home and invest in your future with the businesses that you own and have grown and have purchased. And so ask your questions below. As always, make sure you like this video if you enjoyed this content and want to see more from me. Make sure you subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss anything. And I'm looking forward to continuing to impart whatever knowledge that I have in my head to you and helping you grow along your journey. Thank you so much. I'm Tonya. Be passionate and be profitable.